This past semester, our blended courses have been very successful, and the feedback about our blended learning model has been incredibly positive. That being said, and pending Board of Education approval early next year, we'd like to be prepared to slowly expand our blended learning courses in our district. An important part of this process is to gather the names of teachers that might be interested in teaching a blended course. Enjoy this short video that'll help you to understand a little bit about the blended learning experience in our district. And after watching this video, should you be interested in teaching a blended course, please submit your name to your DL and your principal no later than January 11th.
I teach blended advanced writing at Prairie Ridge High School, which is a class that was offered in a traditional format for many, many years. I think this format can work for all different types of learners. I never really felt like I was differentiating enough for students when I was teaching this class in a traditional format, but in the blended format, I feel like I can differentiate for everybody because I get personal contact with every student in my class.
I originally pursued blended learning, and this is totally teacher driven from my perspective because I saw the need with my students. I just did a survey with my kids, and 61% of my kids don't have a study hall every day, and 15% never have one.
For people like me, I didn't have any free periods through my schedule this year. And with taking other honors classes and other extracurricular classes, I got an opportunity once or twice a week to have a day where I not only got my AP Psych homework done, but I got other class homework done.
The differences between traditional and blended have more to do with how I structure our time. We still cover the same content information which is required by the College Board. And I've taught AP Psychology for 7 years, so I have a wide variety of resources available to me. It's determining which ones I want to use where and how.
As a teacher, it takes flexibility and organization. It's really pushed me to be more organized and to think more ahead because I have to know in advance when the flex days are going to be so I can let the students know. And you have to kind of decide what is crucial for the students to be doing and learning when we're all together in a class. And you have to be able to decide what could they really be exploring on their own.
You can go like at your own pace, like you don't have to stay with the class. Like if you're moving faster, you can go to your flex days and get other homework done as well as the homework that you had in that class. Or if you're going at a slower pace, you can stay in the class and get more personal help.
I've found that the students who would normally struggle in a traditional writing class and maybe fall through the cracks, it's harder for them to fall through the cracks with a blended format because I can make more personal contact with them and they know there's a powerful incentive. They like the flex days, they want the flex days, the flex days are useful for them.
I would recommend the teachers explore blended because it actually appealed to more students than I originally thought. I originally thought that I was going to target those students who didn't have any other time. It was purely scheduling. But what I realized is it allows me to target those students who aren't succeeding and pull them in for additional interventions. And even kids who aren't in my blended class are coming in during my flex days.
I just feel like overall, the power of choice that it gives students, and for that matter, me as a teacher, it's a really powerful thing. It allows them to take charge of their learning.